gathered here in celebration of our graduation, we thank you for all of the blessings you've given us throughout the last 4 years. We thank you for the parents, family members, and friends who have loved and supported us in everything we do. And we thank you for the teachers and administrators who have worked so hard to get us where we are today. We thank you for the relationships that have been built and the community that has been created between us. And Lord, as we finish this chapter of our lives tonight, I ask that you bless each individual with your favor.
I pray strength
and peace into each graduate and their families so that we may be confident in your plans for us. We love you, and I pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Graduates,
you may be seated.
Thank you. would like to thank you for being here tonight to share this evening with us. We are honored by your presence. This is actually the second speech I prepared for tonight. My first speech was a little silly and irreverent, but I was really happy with it until a few days ago. However, as graduation drew nearer and nearer, I began to feel more sentimental about my time in high school. So
I decided
I would rather share a slightly more personal message tonight. So thank you, Mr. Smith, for letting me change my mind at the last minute. I've always believed that graduation will be a time of pure joy and relief. I know we were all definitely ready to leave high school, but big changes can be unnerving, and there's nothing wrong with this. We can mourn the loss of a period of our lives, even though we're excited to move on. In this context, I find the following quote by Robert Brault reassuring. The happiest memories are of moments that ended when they should have. But as we look back and reminisce on the past, I want to emphasize the extreme importance of having a positive retrospective attitude. However cliche it sounds, high school is truly what you make of it. And I mean this
very literally. Every time your brain recalls a memory,
it changes slightly based upon the attitude with which you remember it. Now, we can let this work to our advantage or disadvantage. For example, if you've spent any time talking to and listening to stories from grandparents, you've probably noticed one of two phenomena. They can recall the happiest moments of their lives with a profound bitterness that is heartbreaking to observe. On the other hand, we probably all sat with a grandparent and listened to them laugh their way through a story of a very difficult time in their lives with nothing but joy and humor in their eyes. It's all a matter of attitude. I know we've all had very different experiences in high school. Some of us have had the best times of our lives, others not so much, but for most of us, it's probably been a little bit of both. Whatever the experience has been, these years have shaped us. So let us embrace the memories of the challenges we have endured, so that in the future, we too can have the maturity of mind to cherish them for the ways they shaped us and made us who we are. And perhaps even more importantly, let us protect the positive memories from being transformed into something negative, should we remember them in a moment of bitterness or sadness at some point in the future. The last thing I want to leave you with tonight is this. Let's all be sure to leave high school on a high note. Some of us may never see each other again, so be sure to thank those that need to be thanked, forgive those that need to be forgiven, and ask for forgiveness from those you may have wronged. Do these things to preserve and protect your high school memories. Speaking of memories, here to help us recall some of our class achievements over the past 4 years are Tyler Roberts and Justin Kalamlam.
We congregate here after 4 long years of Wylie High School. 4 long years of hard work, dedication, and passion. 4 long years of sleepless nights, busy weekends, and constant practice. 4 long years of sacrifice, failures, and success. After 4 long years, each one of us will not only be given a diploma, but also this sense that each of us accomplished something greater than ourselves at Wylie High School. That we have made a lasting impression on the school, as well as on the community.
Although this is Wylie's first year competing in Class 5A athletics, we, as a class, have excelled across many sports, displaying our fighting spirit and ability to adapt. The boys' cross-country team was third in the district, while the girls were district champions.
Volleyball is also third in the district overall. And both of the varsity basketball teams were second in their district. Baseball earned back-to-back state championships, and softball made it into the regional semifinals this year. Furthermore, the boys' track team was third in their district, and the girls were district champions. The swim team also qualified for regionals.
The boys' golf team was second in the district, qualifying for regionals, and the girls' golf team went to state. Football also set several unbeatable records, including making a state appearance 2 years ago. and tennis in the fall was the state runner-up, and spring tennis sent a pair of mixed doubles to state.
From speech events to step events to debating and more, our class has always shown just as much spirit and determination in the classroom as on the field. Our UIL academic teams were also faced with many of the new challenges of 5A competitions this year. However, Wylie academics have consistently dominated the district meets in both 4A and 5A, placing first every year since we were freshmen.
Okay, this is epic. We have won our regional meets nearly every year as well, only placing second this year. Members of our class have qualified for state both this year and last for events including computer science, science, and one-act play, even earning the first place trophy at state in computer science last year. Whether competing individually or in teams, those who have competed in academic events have been great representatives of our school.
The Wylie Agricultural Department has also had, and I cannot stress this enough, a very successful year. We had multiple class, breed, division, and grand champions of local, country, and major stock shows.
The livestock team made their fourth appearance at state this year, while the wool team made their third. The ag mechanics team made their second appearance at state. Many students of the class also elected the high state officer position, as well as one state foundation intern.
In addition, many of our five art departments showed the creative color and passion of our class in UIL and other state competitions. The Varsity Mixed Choir and the Varsity Women's Choir earned sweepstakes awards at regionals, and the Wylie non-varsity women's choir received Division I and Division II ratings at regionals.
Furthermore, five seniors qualified for the UIL State Solo and Ensemble Contest. In addition, the band received straight Division I in both UIL contests and marching competitions. The senior members have even made an appearance in the state marching competition and have earned places in the all-region and all-state bands.
The art department was incredibly successful this year and sent three students to the state-based competition, which is due in part to the influence of the legendary Stacy Sanchez. However you may look at it, we are singers, musicians, and artists showing that our class is more than just athletics and academics.
The Destination Imagination teams have never failed to compete at the highest caliber. Our seniors have been regional champions 3 years in a row, have had four state appearances, winning this year by over 60 points, and have had four global finals appearances. This year, a team placed fifth overall at globals and earned first in the instant challenge.
Not only are we students, but also businessmen and women and entrepreneurs. Three seniors were a part of the winning team of the stock market game last year, and many members of the class spearheaded the Purple Dog Company, which is Wylie's first student-run company in history.
One individual even became a social icon, with a viral tweet gaining 45,100 retweets and 150,000 likes. Students of this class also became some of the founding members of new groups and clubs, such as the Wylie Disc Golf Club, the Friends of Rachel Club, and the MedLife Society. Needless to say, Wylie has cultivated pioneers of the future to pave the way for generations to come.
Although we have achieved much of the class to reach this point, let us not forget the dozens of personal successes that each individual has earned. Whether you got a high score on a test you studied so hard for, overcame an obstacle, persevered through tragedy, or or discovering a new passion to follow. Each one of us has succeeded in one way or another, and because of it, each one of us has grown into something great.
However, as we enjoy our victory today, we must acknowledge that we are not finished. As Wylie Bulldogs, we are called to greatness, to achieve more, and to lead others in our communities, wherever they may be. So even though after tonight we depart from one another as classmates, we will continue on to become dentists, engineers, meteorologists, actors, and many more. But whatever we may become, we are and always will be Wylie Bulldogs.
The road does not end here, friends, but it is only the beginning of the rest of our lives. As Abraham Lincoln puts it, the best way to predict your future is to create it. Start today creating a vision for yourself, your life, and your career, and never forget those who helped you along the way. Thanks to the teachers and staff of Wylie, the members of the community, and our families, I am confident that we are all well on the path to achieving great things. Outstanding move, class of 2019. The future is ahead of us.
And remember, as always, it's great to be a Wylie Bulldog. Thank you. And now for your valedictorian, Aaron Ramos.
Junior year was both good so close to the sweet taste of graduation. Most of us finally made varsity. The AP kids took their first real AP exam. Junior year was a lot of growing up. Senior year has been a lot of speeding up and slowing down, especially by the cop, man. This is hard, a lot of ass. Last first football game of the season. Last required course to graduate. Last Taco Tuesday. Last dress code violation. Last time hanging up the jersey. Last curtain call. Last tax deduction. Last it's great to be a white bulldog. Last time we talked to some of these people for the rest of our lives. But there are also some firsts. First college application, nice and stressful. First lottery ticket, you know, always exciting. No one's won anything yet. First tattoo, some of us got it before senior year, but I'm not gonna mention that. Senior year is like a very sweet blur. It's fast, and it is sad, and it is happy all at the same time. High school, being a teenager in general, has taught me anything at all. Obsessing over the future is both necessary and overvalued. Let me explain. Caring a lot about the future is essential to success and reaching towards your goals. Those are both amazing things, but sometimes we get caught up in planning too much. From the start of high school, we've thought about graduating, and depending on how done you personally felt with high school, we've thought about graduating and getting to college, you know, getting out of college. Once we're there, in college, we'll dream of college graduation and our future careers. And then we'll work for decades, eventually dreaming of retirement. Yeah, great things to look forward to.
My point is
that we lose out by living like this. We count down the days till certain events and constantly remind ourselves of both how close and how far these things can be. We always say, let's just make it to the weekend, or let's just make it to the end of the day. What happens is that we end up living life for its ends and not really feeling its moments. It's really cliche to say that we should live in the moment, so I'm not going to. Instead, I'm going to follow up with a quote by the travel to be guardian. He once said, Go and smell roses. Go out and live life in the now. I'm not saying live the life in the past because we've been waiting at least 4 years to get this high school thing done. But you should appreciate what you can about your situation while you're still in it. As I personally reminisce on these past four years, I see that I have learned much more than the Pythagorean theorem, the plot of Jane Eyre, and other exclusively academic knowledge. I have found friends. I learned how to play disc golf. I learned about the glorious fundings of the Annenberg CPP project and the wonderful additional funding by the Geraldine R. Dosh Foundation. We all learned new things. We learned how to not read for a class and still pass the quiz. We also learned that arthropods is all we know. We learned to be true to ourselves. We learned that even if things are not going your way, you should trust the process. We learned that good friends are worth keeping. Some of us learned the art of the Gillette razor blade. We learned that it ain't that deep enough. Some of us learned the importance of support, both giving and receiving. We learned prioritization. Some of us learned that it's okay to not be perfect. Some of us learned how to stand up straight. I also learned what high school is. High school is waking up way too early. It's making new friends. High school is the smell of chemicals in the lab. High school is screaming only vitality because you know no other words than school song. It's yelling your mom's out on Friday nights. High school is going until graduation, and graduation is saying goodbye. Even after this chapter of our lives comes to a close, life goes on, and I hope we all continue to grow into the best versions of ourselves. I will leave you with a quote, one sample, by visionary extraordinaire Kanye or Maury West. Our work is never over. Thank you for sitting through my TED Talk and for coming to our wedding graduation.
Goodbye, class of 2019. We've made it.
Mr. Moore, having fulfilled all requirements as stipulated by the Wylie Board of Education and the Texas Education Agency, I hereby certify that these students receiving a diploma have met all standards for graduation. It is my privilege to present the Wylie High School graduating class of 2019.
Shelby Eileen Addington. Lane Thomas Adkins. Dally Michaela Albus. Connor Jackson Alexander. Ashton Carolyn Alford. Brock Hayden Allen. Joshua Jacob Allen. Valerie Gay Alvarado Colon. Jacob Robert Anders. Madison Day Andrews. Allie Ray Arbolera. Tyler Gregory Arnwine. Amaya Nika Asuncion. Harrison David Atwood. Duncan Trent Bacon. David Gabriel Baker. Samantha Sienna Beach. Gregory Scott Beard. Francisco Javier Becerra Jr. Joshua Charles Beeson. Leandra Danielle Benton. Nathan Quentin Bergen. Emily Ann Byer. Riley Beth Bignell. Lily Renee Bishop. Cade Garrett Blackwell. Kenneth Jerome Bland III. Canton H. Bonda. Peyton Landry Boone. Brooklyn Faith Brewer. Abigail Cameron Brooks.
Kamen G. Brown. Caroline Leanne Brown. Carson Reed Brown. Brianna Joy Bruno. John Christopher Bullard. Kason Thomas Byington. Mark Justin Imaano Kalamwan. Katie Marie Calvert. Robert Anthony Cano. Emma Casey Carter. Alexandria Ashley Jamie. Edwin Seth Chavez. Jessica Nguyen E. Chung. Brianna Nicole Chittum. Alexandra Danielle Clark. Austin Daniel Cloud. Violet Diane Colburn. Dylan Logan Cook. Cassidy Hope Cooper. Landry Isabella Cook. Andrea McKenna Davis. Cody Davis. Gus Quinn Davis. Jordan Alexander Davison. Annika May DeLeon. Jonathan Luke Dylan Dempsey. Ethan Michael Dillon. Cannon Kyle Dobie. Herbert Gordon Dorr. Madison Nicole Doty. Cameron Gabe Dry. Jordan Bray Dunlap. Thad Wade Abilene. Hutter B. Edwards. Emily Lane Edwards. William Cole Edwards. Katie Marie Elo. Evelise Elias Olivera. Ryan Anthony Elizondo. Connor E. Ellis. John David Enriquez. David Reed Epps Segee. Joe Estrada Jr. Cody Michael Bala. Austin Miles Farthing. Edward Lane Beamster. Evan Lee Beamster. Landry Dean French. Hunter James Fulkerson. Dallas Matthew Galbraith. Marley Carr Gamble. Marcus Hunter Ganesh. Zoe A. Garland. Haley Alexis Garrison. Emma Grace Gates. Alexis Michelle Gomez. Joseph Gilvio Elsa Gomez. Brianna Lee Gonzalez. Alexis June Gucci. Alexis Taylor Gregory. Jordan LaVon Guevara. Paige Nicole Guevara. Trey Allen Hagler. Brandon Joseph Hoffman. Alyssa Faith Hall. Stephanie Melissa Howell. Brazis Dixon Ham. Hannah Elise Hammond. Alexandria Nicole Hartwright. Danielle Marie Harmon. Hunter Edlin Harris. Kaylee Christine Harris. Allie Bren Hensley. Abigail Nicole Henson. Jack Henson. Haley Nicole Hervey. Bailey Wayne Hicks. Hannah Elizabeth Hicks. Titan Daniel Hill. Lorena Vasquez Huerta. Shelby Christine Hurt. Philip Anthony Hurtado. Francesca Engel. Brendan Dale Irby. Anna June Davis. Alana Ari DeVay Johnson. Peyton June Johnson. Alexis Raquel Johnston. McKenna Leanne Jones. Alan J. Carr. Hayden Adam Heidel. Alan J. Carr. Hope Marie Kearney. Kristen Michael Kelly. Ashley Marie Kelsey. Hilton Runamoki Kilawasru. Hannah K. Kirby. Macy Alea Kirk. Megan Catherine Kirkland. Jayla K. Hitchens. Madison Felicity Lebrun. Ginger Ann Landon. Justin Christopher Lara. Madison Grace Latham. Benjamin Joseph LeBlanc. Sierra B. Ledford. Laurel May Lemke. Tamara Nicole Levin. Mary Elaine Lovelace. Levi Shine Lucky. Alexis Omar Lujan. Clinton Jackie Mundy. Angel Allison Marianne Lyons. Chloe Marie Martin. Marcus Walton McCarthy. McCarthy. Joby Zane McCurley. Matthew Scott McRoy. Michael Edward McRoy. Ashley Danielle Medina. Brandon Wade Miser. Kathleen Elise Messer. Hope Mackenzie Miller. Jacob Ryan Miller. Billable Muhammad. Max Wills Money. Dalen Riggs Moore. Nathan Scott Moore. Tobin H. Moore. Haley K. Nicole Boots. Kelly Denise Morris. Adrian Jan Miller. Caleb Daniel Munson. Jacob Ryan Nelson. Kana Lynn Nelson. Sydney Van Long Quinn. Karina Danette Odom. Coy Paul Austin. Madison Bailey Owen. Drew Koresh. Taylor Lauren Parrish. Haley Marie Parker. Ashlyn Sarah Patton. Grace Aaron Payne. Alexandria Hope Peters. Weston L. Pettit. Aaron O'Neill High. Dakota P. Quinn. Michaela Rader. Haley Ryan Rainey. Christian Tyler Ramirez. Aaron Russell Allegado Romo. Jamie Ramos. Jamie Lachey Valenti Ramos. Nicole C. Reister. Nicholas C. Reister. Saint Kael Rempel. Grant Samuel Reyes. Eric John Richardson. Jamie Renee Riddle. Amanda Marie Robertson. Riley Joe Robertson. Tyler E. James Roberts. Reagan Brooke Robertson. Adriana Cache Robertson. Jacob Riley Rogers. Cameron David Renee Rosas. Alden R. Ross. Ashley Sines. Jacob Marcus Sanchez. Catherine Grace Sanchez. Brandon Todd Sanders. Parker Wayne Sanford. Declan Gregory Solly. Ian Patrick Callier. Bennett Nicholas Jackman. L. Ryan Schroeder. William Allen Schultz. Gabrielle Renee Scher. Jackson Robert Thurman. Joshua Thomas Schuler. Travis Lee Smart. Jasmine Nicole Smith. Kylan Luann Smith. Alexandra Nicole Jellymushi. Tyler Jacob Spears. Jaden Wayne Siegel. Allison Joy Sedman. Madison Rose Stein. Ethan Robert Stewart Duke. Lauren Nicole Stromer. Malia Ann Sutton. Grace Elizabeth Taylor.
Krista Yvonne Thomas. Nicholas Jan Thornbiss. Alexandra Christine Thornton. Kylie Ryan Thornton. Calvin Joseph Kiner. Austin James Tucci. Caleb Martin Tucker. Josiah Teagle. Micah Teagle. Ruben James Ulloa. Riley Ray Valentine. Nathaniel E. Vaughn. Jaden Anthony Villanueva. Jonathan Charles Vendua. Jackson Thomas Boat. Blake Larson Wadley. Justin Thomas Walker. Devin Ali Warner. Stephen Ty Webb. Sutton Bays Welch. Brianna Nicole Westbrook. We would now like to take a moment to honor a graduate who is not able to attend tonight's ceremony. Please welcome Madison Williams, accepting the diploma of her brother, Dylan Garman Williams. Jacqueline Jo Williams. Skylar Alexis Williams. Devin Ray Williford. Kylie Barrett Wilson. Samantha Therese Wilson. Haley Brooke Winter. Allison Michelle Witherspoon. Sarah Therese Wolf. Haley Archer Womack. Harley Archer Womack. Woman. Peyton Ryan Wood. Carter Dane Wright. Nevin Akbar Yastani. Catherine Jane Alice Yost. Elena Grace Young. Aaron Noel Zachary.
Please pray with me. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us here today. Thank you for the many laughs, tears, and hugs we've shared over the last 4 years. And thank you for giving us this time to celebrate its accomplishments. We thank you for those here that have stood behind us through it all, and we thank you for blessing this journey of ours and the one to come. God, I ask that as we leave here today, we remember you and honor you in all that we do. I pray that we remember this Wylie family, and that more than that, we keep in mind that we're all brothers and sisters in Christ, here for you. I ask that we show the same love and kindness to others down the road as we've been shown here. And God, I ask most importantly of all, that we always know that no matter our accomplishments or failures, we have a God that loves us unconditionally, and that's all we really need. We're also missing a pretty special member of our class tonight. God, we ask that as you continue to heal Dylan, our community can continue to rally for and support him. And even though he couldn't be here, we just ask that he knows how much we love him and are all praying for him. We love you, God, and we ask for your blessing as we head into the next step of our lives, and that you'll keep us and our family safe as we travel home tonight. And it's in your Son Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. Graduates, please rise.